Wow, recently a lot of Malaysians are all talking about this guy, you know. Wow, he's a failed comedian, and then like he's shunned by society, nobody like him one. And then he got some mental problem, you know, so he end up saying and doing a lot of crazy things one, you know. Ooh.
Hey, you're talking about Joker, is it?
Who's Joker? I'm talking about the clown prince of parliament, Ahmad Mazlan.
Sorry, it's DJ.
Welcome to episode 6 of Ho Sim Lang Years. I am back. Long time no see, long time no see. Today, we start a conversation with our Menteri of Nasi Goreng, Mr. Ahmad Mazlan, because he say he's going to offer free consultation services to the government about GST. Oh, free, for free. Now, my friends always tell me, say, ho, if you are good at something, never do it for free. So I think Mr. Mazlan can afford to do this for free lah. Recently, the Malaysian Institute of Economic Research, they say actually GST is better than SST and Malaysia needs it. But for Malaysians, GST is like siham, you know, like kerang, you know, you're not kerang. Very nice. Okay, so some people are just scared of it already, okay? Some people are scared of it because the last time they ate siam, they ate it after clubbing, you know, after 3 a.m. in the morning, you finish clubbing, then you go outside, you be checking, and you see lolo trot, then lolo, oh lolo trot, then you go lolo trot, where you go? You go and take the last 2 sticks of siam. And then next day you party on your toilet, you all outside. Food poisoning, diarrhea. And that is the last time you want to eat siham ever again, right? Just like GST. And same like siham, some people feel that as long as siham is clean, is done correctly, is not corrupted, then it should be fine, you should be able to eat. So depends on how it's treated lah. So different kind of approach. And then I've got some people, also again like GST and all that system, some people just want to eat siham no matter what. They don't care one. They all outside 5,000 times, they will still go lolo chat, eat the last stick of siham. Okay lah, it's good business for the lolo chat. Support your local business and support the local economy. Very good. And another problem some people have is like, we all cannot agree on like how siham should be implemented into our regular life, you know, just like GST like that. Should it be in char kway teow, or should it be only in curry noodle? You know, some people like their char kway teow without siham, some like their curry noodle without siham. Or, you know, how to cook it? Should it be with sambal, or just with rebus, or kerang bakar, or kerang kerabu, or nasi lemak, you know, with like sambal kerang, very nice, or kambiong, so sedap. A lot of ways to cook siham. Anyway, at the end of the day, it really doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what everyone got different preference. Some people like siham, some people like lala, you know, and all like same with the tax system, got all kind of different type. And both can be good or bad for you, depending on how it's done. You might not even like siham at all. You might not even like lala. You might not even like oyster. You might not even like ojian. What kind of person are you? I don't know. But I don't judge. Maybe you like nasi goreng strawberry. But I think we can all agree lah, whether it's siham or lala or ojian or nasi goreng strawberry, as long as it is not dirty, corrupted, and it is done properly, most people won't have to all outside lah, you know? At least everybody can have a good time, can get on your life, you know, things might not be perfect or exactly the way you want it, but at least you don't have diarrhea, right? Okay, that's it for this episode. I am going to go clubbing now, and then I'm going to get lolo. And after lolo, I go home, and then I hope I don't all outside. Yeah. Remember, last siham, try not to touch. A bit dangerous, okay?